Diagonalization can be used to show that some problem is not computable. I will now tell you about another technique called a Cook reduction, which can also be used to show that something is not computable, as long as you already have some other problem for which you know that it is not computable. The basic motivation behind a Cook reduction is the question, suppose we could compute problem G. What other problems could we compute? So if we had some procedure of computing G, we could write programs that consist of normal computational steps, and then some calls to this procedure that we have that solves G. So in pseudocode, you might get something like this, right? So you do some standard computation steps, like V is equal to A plus 3, and then B is equal to 3 times A, and so on. And then at certain points, you call this procedure for function G. So you say, okay, so now I want to know what G of V is. And then you do some more steps, like you compute y equals x plus 2, and then maybe you ask again the procedure for g, what is g of y? And then you do another step, you add z to y, and then you return the result. I mean, this is just a silly example, this doesn't do anything useful. It's just to kind of demonstrate how in principle this could work. Now, we want to formalize this idea using Turing machines. And for that, we use a notion of a so-called oracle Turing machine. Sometimes it's also just called an oracle machine. So an oracle machine is a Turing machine with a special additional tape called the oracle tape. And the machine has additional special states. Let's call them Q-ask and Q1 and Q0. The computation of the oracle machine on some input x with access to an oracle to a function g is defined based on the transition function. For internal states which are different from Q-ask and Q1 and Q0, everything is as it would normally be in a Turing machine. However, when the Turing machine enters the internal state Q-ask, it means it's now asking a question to the oracle. And then in a similar step, the machine will move to internal state Q1 or Q0, depending on whether G of Z is equal to 1 or 0, where Z is the contents of this special oracle tape at this point in time. So basically what the Turing machine can do is it can write down a question in the form of a bit string onto the oracle tape. It then enters the internal state Q-ask, which means, oracle, please tell me whether G of this question is equal to 1 or 0. And the oracle will instantly reply and switch the machine to internal state Q1 or Q0, depending on whether G of Z is 1 or 0. If we have some oracle machine OM and we execute it on input X and the machine uses an oracle for function G, then we write the result of this computation as OMG of X. A side note here is that we can also define oracle machines in such a way that the oracle is not necessarily a function that maps to 0 or 1, but it's a general problem, so the output could be a bit string rather than just a single bit. In that case, of course, it wouldn't be possible to give the answer by switching to an internal state, Q0 or Q1. Instead, the answer would have to be written down in some special tape, and then the oracle machine can read the answer from there. However, we will not really use such machines here, so this is just a side note that technically this is possible, but we will not need this. These Oracle machines now give us an answer to our initial question. Which problems f can be computed if we can compute this function g? A problem f is cook-reducible to a problem g if there exists an Oracle machine with access to Oracle g that computes f. When f is cook-reducible to g, we write this as f is cook-reducible to g. If you need some intuition behind this, you can think about this as g is as difficult to compute as f. Or the other way around, f is no more difficult to compute than g. If I cannot compute f, I can also not compute g. But if I can compute g, I can compute f as well. So this helps in establishing that problems are not computable. Because suppose we have some function f for which we already know that it is not computable. And then if we have a Cook reduction from f to some other problem g, well, then we know that g is also not computable. So we got a new result that g is not computable, just from the fact that f is not computable and there is this Cook reduction from f to g. Cook reductions are a really, really important and powerful concept, so you have to make sure that you understand them.